Hey guys, welcome to the Prep and Preacher channel. I'm Brother Tim. I'm so glad you're here, and I hope God's truly blessing you. If you hadn't noticed, man, our news cycle is hitting us fast and furious. Where it used to be a 24, 48-hour news cycle, now we're talking hours and minutes that are hitting us with new articles, new news reports. All really, I believe, is fear-mongering. A lot of it is, but it also is indicators of that dark winter is coming. Folks, let's take a look and see what we can do to prepare ourselves for it. Stay tuned. As I said, this is the Prep and Preacher channel. I'm Brother Tim, and I'm so glad you're here, and I hope God is truly blessing you. Hey, I'll save you a little time on the front end, guys. This channel, we stand for pro-God. We stand for pro-family. We stand for pro-life. That means not the murder of innocent babies. We stand pro-Second Amendment. That means guns, all right? That Second Amendment is what protects that First Amendment. Don't you ever forget it. And we also stand pro-military and police, guys. And we support our veterans, of which I'm one. And so if any of them offend you, well, I say it and I'll keep saying it. Skippy, you can find you another channel. Man, just be an adult, change the channel, go on your other way. But you guys that have been here, that are staying with us, that are getting our voice out, well, God bless you, man. I am truly touched with all the comments, with all the likes. Folks, y'all touch my heart all the time. And I want to thank you for that support. Now, again, this video here is all these indicators we're seeing. All these different articles are hitting. You see, Augustin Farms, that just I put that out just a few days ago, that they're shutting down for 90 days, shutting down production for 90 days, and so nothing's going out. Whatever's on the shelves now, if you need Augustin Farms, I'd suggest you get it now, but you're not going to find it really on sale. That's the sad thing about it. But the question I got is that means they're going to crank back up January of 2022. Where's the food coming from? Where are the crops coming from that they're going to be putting up? That's the question I got. Now see, if I was optimistic, I would hope right now that they're building up their supplies right now. But if I was pessimistic, I would be thinking it's going to be longer than 90 days. And that's just one article. What we need to do there is we need to start watching Mountain House and Providian, some of these others that put food out. Now, if you don't understand, I'll put a don't look at Four Patriots. Their products, to me, they're substandard. Okay, and they can take me up on it. But the taste test, I tell you what, that was the hardest thing to get out of my mouth eating some of their food. And I'll put a link up here. I'm going to tell you when things are good. I'm going to tell you when things are bad, guys. And if you don't want the truth, well, again, there's another channel out there for you. But start looking at Mountain House, Providian, some of them, if you're wanting to put up some long-term storage food. So what do we do here? Well, the wife and I, what we're doing, we're still looking, making food our number one priority. We're buying the Keystone meat when we can find and putting it up. We're putting more rice up. We're putting more beans up. We're putting up flour. We're putting up sugar. We're putting up salt. Everything we can, man. Okay, so if you've got a year, so what? Do 2 years. If you've only got a week, well, get 2 weeks. Just make that your number one. Another thing, too, that we're looking at, number two, is our supplements. When I say supplements, I'm talking about our vitamins, the supplements like zinc, the supplements like iron. Try to put back, and that's what we've done, is put back a couple of years because of the expiration date, a couple of years of them. Now, we use the Nature Made. That's the brand we like, and it's had good reviews on it. And then you may have another kind, and this is not an exhaustive list of what kind to get, but I try to put some multivitamins back for me, you know, and I got to get them for that 50 plus, you know, nowadays. But try to put the iron back, the zinc back. Also, third thing that you need to look at, if you remember the last time when this China flu hit, you couldn't find any cold or flu or sinus relief. I would go ahead and start getting some of that and stockpiling that right now. All right, people say, don't hoard it. No, you get it, and so you can take care of yourself and your family. Get it now while you can. Get some of the Zicam and some of the different stuff there for the colds and flus, because I'm telling you, it's not going to be on the shelf. And they're not even saying about how much of that it may be manufactured here in America, but some of the ingredients or even the packaging may be coming from overseas. That's one thing that we're seeing right now with the food, especially. McCormick's has come out and said that they're having packaging issues on some of their spices. They got the spices, but they have no way of packaging them and selling them. Another one, ConAgra. ConAgra is huge. Well, they said that, and they do the Marie Callender frozen food, and I don't really eat it, but they're saying that they're having packaging issues, and they've shut down production on that line. So I come across a report, and I'll put a link in my description here. But IRI is a company that does statistics, and they do reporting of what's in stock or not in stock. They track basically the stock levels of groceries. And in their last report for October 3rd, they said that frozen, there was 15% not on the shelves. Candy and snacks, also 15%. Beverages, 18%, and bakery items, 18%. Okay, if it's affecting those, and you got to understand now, these are all products that have been manufactured, made, foods that are already made here. They have to have the ingredients to make those, and there's where they're running into problems, okay? And this whole shipping fiasco that we're looking at is affecting us all the way across, even to where the major transport companies have gone. Why they would go to who, the World Health Organization, I'll never know, but they've gone to them and said, the leaders of the country's got to do something because it's in shambles right now. And I think a lot of reason they went to WHO was so that there would be some kind of regulation on the China virus, on how they can come in and out of ports, because every country's different. So here it is. It's another way that it's being shut down. They're talking about toilet paper again, not so much the paper itself, but the little cardboard spools that the toilet paper goes on, shortage of them. Possibly the plastic. So we're seeing shortage after shortage. They're talking turkeys at Thanksgiving. Man, they're covering the whole wealth. And but, you know, according to our government, there is no shortage. But there's some things that will be missing in the grocery stores. Go figure, the government. But so food's our number one priority. Supplements was our number two. We've got our water situation squared away. Now, if you don't have your water situation squared away, you need to get it there. Get you some good purifiers for your water. Get the Berkeys, man. They're great. Build your own Berkey. I'll put a link up here for it. But after that, you need to look at your power, okay? You need to look at your power because they're talking about grayouts in certain areas. It may never hit here in the great state of Tennessee. I don't know. But I like to have a backup to a backup. And so that's what we do. We have generators that use propane. So I'm storing more propane. I'm getting it now. It's already gone up. I've seen an increase now from $15.99 for a 15 pounder to $19.99. It may be $29.99 by next week. Matter of fact, just a side note, I put my freedom seeds, and that's for the non-patriots in the group. I put my ammunition in these MTM cases. I love to use them, these plastic cases. And I'll put a picture up here. Well, I've seen them in the last year go from $14.99 to $19.99. That may not sound like a lot of money, but that's a 42% increase in a year. Now, these are made in the USA, but they're still having production problems getting stuff in and getting stuff transported to them. All right, so, but back to the power. If you're using propane, get you some propane. Get it in. If you're using heating oil, get that heating oil now, okay? Also, look at ways of generating power. We're increasing our solar capacity is what we're doing right now on that. Now, that takes care of really our food, our water, our supplements, and our power. And that propane also, I use it to heat also. And I'll be doing a video here. I'm working on it right now on a way to heat your home, portable, that you can use. That's relatively inexpensive or cheaper than trying to put a whole unit in. So, but try to take care of that. Now, the next thing we're looking at is we're trying to protect what wealth we have. And now we don't have a lot of wealth, but try to protect some of it, because the dollar that we have, our U.S. currency, it is a fiat currency. It's not backed by anything. Trying to protect our wealth, the first thing I look at, I try to put about 20% of our savings into precious metals. When I say precious metals, I'm talking silver and gold. All right, and right now silver's at $22.50 spot, and I think gold's at $1,750 spot. That's per ounce, which is the gold's a little bit high. The silver has become has come down quite a bit in the last few months, and it's kind of a bargain. I try to put back. I don't like to buy the silver rounds that are really kind of no name. I try to put silver eagles back, and I try to put what they call junk silver, which is coins, U.S. coins minted, a quarter, a dime, a half, minted 1964 before. That way I can, you know, they're 80%, and people realize and they understand what that is if I ever have to use it. And see, that's a kind of a fluid. You can sell your silver, you can sell your gold if you need to. And I've always had mine go up. I've been fortunate. God's blessed me with that. And so I, you know, you can always, always use it more so than you can, say, the dollars. Now, after that, I look at tangible goods and putting stuff in tangible goods. If you're looking to do solar, go to it. If you're looking to get that Berkey pump, go to it, because your dollar's going to buy less. If it, the economy keeps going the way it is, it's going to be buying less. So go ahead and get some of the staples that you're looking for. Maybe an early Christmas gift of that Berkey or that solar system or whatever it may be, but tangible things you can put your hands on that you can use when the hard times come. It could be a grain mill. It could be, it's a plethora of things. It could be that freedom stick, okay, and freedom seeds to have put back that you've been thinking about getting, but use that. Another tangible is land, but right now land prices are really around our area are through the roof. And so, to me, it's not that economical to pick up any land right now. I'm still watching. If there's a good one that comes up, I might try to get it, but it's got to be a bargain. It's got to be a bargain. So, now, you're talking about land, and I'll say this real quick, just to end this. A lot of people can't afford a place to bug out or a place to go, a place to homestead. Guys, this is the time to start networking. As brothers and sisters in Christ and preppers, this is a time to start networking. The person with that homestead might not be able to put a solar system in, but you may be able to do the solar system, and they've got the land. They may not have the water filtration. This is the time to network and pool our sources together, but choose wisely. Choose wisely. You make sure they're a brother or sister in Christ. Don't unequally yoke yourself. But that's one reason we bought the preppingpreacher.com. We're trying to work and get a forum up where it's a community and we can discuss between us. We can find people in our areas. Man, you wouldn't realize how many are right there around you that you don't even know. And that way, you know, we can feel each other out, see what's going on, and see if we do want to be part of that group. All right, but it's time to network. Because, you know, it's that old song, man, I got a pair of roller skates and you got a brand new key. And I think we can work together. That's what we got to do. But guys, don't let all the news articles scare you. Again, he did not give us a spirit of fear. He gave us a spirit of power. He gave us his power. Okay. He gave us a spirit of love. He gave us his love. And praise God, he gave us a sound mind. And that sound mind is that's the sense that's not common anymore. Use it. Use it. Work to the good. Work for the kingdom, guys. Until I see you again, I'm praying God may richly bless you and you'll continue to stand in that gap. This is the Prep and Preacher, guys. I'm out of here.